two, three, go. So, Kate, just tell me, how are you feeling considering you're going to be hosting this thing tonight?
I'm very excited. I love the organization, and I love what they do, not only in showing and rewarding people who are doing positive images of the GLBT community, but also really educating the media about what is a good thing, you know, what is a good image of gay people.
And why do you think it's so hard to get those positive images of the LGBT community out there in the mainstream?
It's the closeted homosexuals that are running the industry. And their self-hating selves. Is that okay, honey?
It feels good. It feels good to participate in advocating equal rights for every segment of our society. And this is one that's been underrepresented and often doesn't get enough attention. You know, ensuring that we have fair and accurate representations of members of the gay, lesbian, bisexual, transgender community, this is important.
Sort of give us the inspiration. For those who haven't read the magazine, why Bleu came into existence?
Well, hopefully everyone has read the magazine, but Bleu is a reflection of me and my friends and my surroundings. There weren't lots of images of myself in the media, so I wanted to create my own representation of who I was in the media. It's for urban men of color, gay or straight, in most metropolitan areas.
So nice to see you again.
They need to have him on the cover of Bleu magazine.
Well, have him come over. Obviously a great person to have on our cover, but you graced our cover about a couple, maybe four issues back. Tell us how that experience was for you.
It was awesome to be recognized, you know, by the black gay community. I think that was one of the biggest honors because, you know, the mainstream white publications haven't put me on the national ones haven't put me on the cover. So.
Tell us about how it was working on the movie after transitioning from the TV show.
It was great doing the movie. You know, it was challenging. We wanted to make a film that would appeal to fans of the show, but at the same time attract people who maybe hadn't had a chance to check out the series. So that was not an easy thing to do, but I think it was a fun thing to do.
And you've done now a couple of movies where you particularly like to depict the lives of African-American gay men. Is that just because of own personal reasons or one of the areas where...
I mean, I guess because I am an African-American gay man, it's just... subject matter that I know and that I care about, and as an artist, that's the best stuff to portray in your work.
I'm very excited about being nominated. We haven't been nominated by GLAAD before, and I think it was because the show was on the gay network, and they weren't at that point recognizing shows on gay network because they felt like we were sort of preaching to the choir. And you know, GLAAD is all about stepping outside of our own community and checking our representation in other areas. What's great about the show is it is reaching people outside of our community. It is showing folks who didn't necessarily know before that, you know, we're living very three-dimensional lives. We are going to work and having relationship trouble and car trouble, and we're human.
What is it to that dimension that, you know, there's a prize value placed on masculinity in the black gay community as opposed to a femininity?
Well, I think that's actually happening across the board. I don't know if that's just in the black community. I think that gay folks have in the last 10 years or so really come to glorify looking like straight folks or sort of mimicking straight men. And it's really hard to say where it comes from, but I would say that when Patrick put the show together, she was very deliberate about making this sort of hero of the show, having him challenge those notions and having him really sort of ride the fence between masculine and feminine.
I'm a diva. I'm a diva. What was it like for you to take that role, which was for you the first of its kind, but even pulling you outside of what you normally do?
It was great. I mean, you know, as scary of a choice as it was for me at first, it was ultimately everything that I've ever dreamed of as an actor. You know, a role that took me outside of myself, you know, that not only entertained but educated, and from what has come about has validated a lot of people in their own personal lives. You know, it's been a phenomenal roller coaster ride.
Obviously, America's Next Top Model has a huge gay following and a large gay minority following. What is it about the show that connects with those particular groups so much?
You know, it's the Cinderella story. And whether you really have any aspirations about, you know, becoming a model, or not, you know, getting this back kind of behind the scenes glimpse of an industry that's all glitz and glamour, that's almost impossible to become a part of. You know, I think that's what fascinates, you know, the gay community. I think they love it. They love to see the art direction. They love to see the hair. They love to see the makeup. They love to see the models. They love Tyra. And really, I think that's why the show in general has such a broad appeal. We call it, do I look like old money or new money?
Oh, and this is freshly minted, apparently.
Well, no. You want to look like old money.
Oh, do you?
Old money means mad. New money means you're shining like a copper penny and that's not cute.
Oh.
Okay, you're giving me old money right now. That's a good thing.
Okay, good. Even though I have no money. Is there anything to dish about working with Tyra?
She's like a glamorous fembot. They feed her lines, she does them impeccably, and then she can vacuum the floor with her ass like a Roomba.